What happens after a tooth is removed?
So after a tooth is removed, bone naturally heals by shrinking. So in other words, if you can just imagine that this is the socket where the tooth sits, here's our tooth, here's our socket. When a tooth is removed, that socket or that bone heals by shrinking like that. So in about 3 to 6 months, the bone is significantly thinner than what it used to be when the tooth was there. The most shrinkage happens in the first 3 months after a tooth is removed, but it continues to shrink up to 12 months, and after 12 months there is still some shrinkage, but most shrinkage happens in the first 3 months and up to 12 months.
What is a socket graft and when is needed?
So if we are planning to replace your tooth with an implant, we want to preserve that bone, we want to minimize shrinkage. There will be shrinkage regardless. We can't prevent it 100%, but we can significantly reduce it, because when we want to go to come back and put an implant in, we want to have nice, solid bone, good volume of bone to receive that implant. Therefore, we have a procedure that's called a socket graft. So just to go back to that simplistic explanation, the tooth comes out. To prevent this, we want to maintain that socket. We put some little chips of bone inside the socket and allow it to heal with those little bone particles. That way, bone doesn't shrink anywhere near as much. It shrinks a little bit, but it's still not enough to cause problems with implant procedure. Now, those bone particles could be either of human origin, from a human cadaver, it could be from an animal source, or it could be from a synthetic source. Evidence tells us that synthetic bone is nowhere near as effective as other sources. Animal bone is commonly used, not so extensively around the world, but here in Australia is very popular. It is not as good as human bone. It doesn't solidify as quickly. So when we come back to place implant in, you have to wait a lot longer if the dentist puts animal bone in there, whereas human bone turns into bone that's ready to receive an implant within 3 to 4 months. And it actually turns into your own bone and turns into your own DNA. So it is quite an incredible material. It is derived from human donor bone. Essentially, it is treated, screened for viruses, so it is perfectly safe. And it's like a calcium and phosphate matrix that allows your own bone to grow into and turns into your own bone that's ready to receive an implant.
Can a socket graft be done a few days or months after extraction?
Unfortunately, it can't be. So the socket graft has to be done on the same day as the tooth is removed. Reason being is after the tooth is removed, the natural healing response by the body is to fill in the socket with a blood clot, and that blood clot is the first step in bone formation, and this happens within minutes of tooth coming out. Now, if we remove the tooth, allow that blood clot to form, and if you come back a few days later, we need to disturb the socket. We have to disturb that healing process again, clean out the blood clot, and then do the socket graft. So technically it's possible, but why would you want to delay for another day and have two surgeries instead of one? Now, another question that some patients ask me, can I do it a few months later? So some people ring us and say, I had a tooth removed by another dentist. We ask them, did you have a socket graft? And they say, no, socket graft wasn't recommended. Can I come to you and have the socket graft? Because I do want an implant there. It's in that situation, we generally recommend not to bother with a socket graft, especially if the tooth was removed months earlier. Because if you wait a few months, bone starts forming. You can't easily go in and clean that bone out to put a socket graft in. It doesn't make sense in a situation like that. Just leave it, let it heal. There's a good chance that you might still have enough bone for an implant. Maybe not as much as if you did have a socket graft done, but often you still have enough of it.
How much does a socket graft cost?
A socket graft typically costs a few hundred dollars. It's not overly expensive. Considering that you are already paying a few hundred dollars to have a tooth removed, to add that assurance that you're likely to have enough bone for an implant down the track, you are paying another maybe a few hundred dollars, $300, $400. So to give you a good indication, a dentist might charge maybe $600, anywhere from $600 to $1,000 to have a tooth removed and socket graft performed.
What can increase the risk of a socket graft failure?
An infection, a pre-existing infection or a post-operative infection. So if we are removing a tooth because it has an underlying infection, it is advisable to firstly take a course of antibiotics starting one day before you have the tooth removed to contain that infection and minimize the risk of it being active on the day of extraction. And at the time of the tooth being removed, a dentist will typically clean out the socket. It's called curetting the socket, cleaning out the infected area, again minimizing the risk of an infection becoming active all of a sudden and causing socket graft failure. And another reason why a socket graft might fail is a post-operative infection. So you might not have the infection before the tooth is removed, but simply because you've had a surgery and you've got an open wound in your mouth, bacteria from the mouth can seed inside the socket and cause a localized infection of the socket. And what we know too well is any infection is acidic in nature and acids dissolve bone. They dissolve your own natural bone and they'll also dissolve grafted bone. As I mentioned earlier, antibiotics are often recommended as a prophylactic measure, whether you've got an existing infection or we're trying to prevent a post-operative infection to minimize the risk of any bone graft failure.
How long do I need to wait to have an implant done after socket graft?
It all depends on what sort of material was used for the socket graft. If human donor bone is used, generally 4 months after the socket graft is the best time to put the implant in. At 3 months is when we generally recommend to have a scan. From that scan, the dentist can assess if the area is ready for an implant, and at 4 months is the perfect time when the bone solidifies enough to hold that implant. If the socket graft is of animal origin, generally comes from a cow, then it takes a lot longer to solidify, generally up to 9 months. 7 to 9 months is the best time to place an implant. So animal materials are not the best for socket grafts. If synthetic bone is used, and it's not so commonly used, but again, around 3 to 4 months mark.